Welcome back to the IBSP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome to the 2021 IBFP Boxing Awards. And look, let's break it down honestly and objectively as possible. And this is not your typical award show. You know, a lot of channels do it completely different. But you know me, I'm no holds barred. I do it honestly and objectively. But I'm also 100% blunt. Honest. I'm not going to hold back. I'm not going to tiptoe around your feelings, and I'm not going to make you feel okay about your favorite fighter being a coward. So let's break it down honestly and objectively as possible. And the Ducker of the Year award goes to Jermall Charlo, and he's worked extremely hard for this award this year. I mean, when you look at Jermall Charlo, this guy ducked Danny Jacobs, a prime opportunity to make that fight, and he chose a cherry pick instead. Jermall Charlo ducked David Benavidez at least twice in 2021, made a ton of excuses. He's too young. He doesn't have a belt. He needs to get a vaccine. He doesn't wipe his own ass. Every 5 minutes, Jermall Charlo has a different excuse why he cannot fight David Benavidez. And not only that, you know, he also ducked Demetrius Bubu Andre, a potential unification fight, after saying he'd be open to the fight. He just ran away from the fight like an absolute coward. He is absolutely the ducker of the year. No one has outdone all the work Jermall Charlo has put in 2021, because this man is clearly the ducker of the year, and it's not even close. Let's keep it going. The next one goes to the hater of the year. And you know, Floyd Mayweather is the hater of the year, and no one has worked as hard at being a hater this year than Floyd Money Mayweather. I mean, this is the same guy who said Canelo's a hell of a fighter, but in my opinion, he's ducking David Benavidez. Now, you know, the funny thing about that is he forgot to mention that Canelo Alvarez beat every champion at 168 pounds. He forgot that David Benavidez is not a world champion. But it's no wonder coming from Floyd, since Floyd has never cleaned out a full division. Floyd has never done what Canelo's done. So, of course, he would call the guy who's done more than him in that respect as a ducker? Make it make sense. Even David Benavidez doesn't think Canelo Alvarez is ducking him. This is the same Benavidez who said, I need to earn a Canelo Alvarez fight. I guess Floyd missed that memo. Floyd also went in to start disrespecting Canelo Alvarez at the Tank Davis post-fight press conference. And the funny thing about it is Canelo Alvarez had nothing to do with that. Nothing. He was in no way, shape, or form involved. And Floyd just could not keep this man's name out of his mouth. Floyd kept the hate going by saying Canelo's not pound for pound number one. Terrence Crawford is. But then Terrence Crawford came out and said Canelo Alvarez is pound for pound number one. It's clear that Floyd cannot stop the hate. Floyd also went on to say Tank Davis is the face of boxing, not Canelo Alvarez. I mean, the hate gets dumber and dumber every second of the day. It's clear that he's jealous and hating on Canelo Alvarez's status as the best fighter in the world and accomplishing something he never did by going undisputed. But let's keep it going. The Dumbass of the Year award goes to no other duo than Teofimo Lopez Sr. and Jr. And these guys are the complete Dumbasses of the Year award. And look, let me break it down. First of all, Teofimo Lopez Sr. stated that Teofimo won every round against George Kambosos Jr. That is probably the dumbest thing I've ever heard. And his dumbass son, Teofimo Lopez, says, everybody knew I won the fight. I scored it 10-2. You mean 10-2 the other way? Because you definitely did not win 10 rounds in that fight, dumbass. But let's keep it going. And the Robbery of the Year award has to go to Jermall Charlo robbing the Brian Castaño fight. I mean, when you look at it, Brian Castaño should be undisputed right now. Everybody knows Brian Castaño won that fight. And he was robbed because the fight was in Texas. It was on PBC. It's Jermall Charlo had everything working in his favor. Brian Castaño would have had to get a knockout to get the victory that night. I mean, everything was working against Brian Castaño. Jermall Charlo's own mama knew Castaño won that fight. Not only that, you've even seen Terrence Bud Crawford says, draw, y'all funny. He also goes on to say, Jermall Charlo lost and I'm done talking about it. Not only did Terrence Crawford see that he lost the fight, Canelo Alvarez saw him lose the fight as well. Even Brian Castaño still protests to this day. I beat Jermall Charlo. At the end of the day, we know that was the robbery of the year, and Castaño should be undisputed. But let's keep it going. And the fighter of the year is none other than Saul Canelo Alvarez. This guy went undisputed in 2021, stopped two undefeated world champions who had never took a loss. There was no blueprint to beat these guys, and Canelo Alvarez stopped them in unified belts to become undisputed in 2021. He's clearly the fighter of the year because no one's put in the work he's put in this year. Let's keep it going. And the trainer of the year has to be Eddie Reynoso. And, you know, he's also been elected boxing trainer of the year. I mean, when you look at Eddie Reynoso, he had an elite, incredible, great year, a legendary year. He got Ryan Garcia a stoppage win over Luke Cool Hand Campbell. Everybody said he would lose that fight. Oscar Valdez, stoppage win over Miguel Burchelt. You know, you've even seen him get a win with Andy Ruiz Jr. over Chris Areola. And then we've seen him get, you know, Canelo Alvarez multiple wins over Billy Joe Saunders and Caleb Plant, stopping both of those guys, undefeated world champions in their prime. Eddie Reynoso is on a roll, has lost no major fights in 2021, and it showed that he's truly an elite trainer.